Dear CG thinkers, welcome. How to make grids that follow the curvature of an object? Indeed, this is a question I am often asked. You know that Fluent offers a tool that allows you to create grids in the holes you have cut with the add-on. But as good users, you are always ready to go further and push the limits. Today, I finally give you the technique to do this. Open Blender, drag this video to your second screen, and let's go. Call the creation tool and right-click on the floor to display the grid and draw your basic object. I remind you that it is the holding of the shift key that allows you to draw the rectangle from the center. We will continue by editing a first bevel, which will be the only one adjustment that we will add. Once this is done, I leave Fluent and add a bevel on the object. We continue with the only cut of this object, an inset. I display the grid with a right click on the surface. I draw a rectangle and I validate with a left click. I adjust the depth of the inset to accentuate it a little, and I finalize the cut with the addition of a mirror effect. That is, the starting situation is set and we can begin to add the grid. For those who know, we do as usual. We display the Boolean object, we select the object that makes the cut, and we call the grid tool. By holding down the left click, I display the circular menu, which allows me to choose the type of grid I want to add. The grid appears. I will simply adjust its size with the scale button. And now you will have to use your head. Remember this, just because you use an add-on doesn't not mean that the rest of the software disappears. An add-on provides some functions, but you can always go beyond that by mixing what an add-on does with your knowledge of Blender. We will then leave the add-on and ask the question, how can I deform an object in Blender? As you can imagine, there are several answers to this question, but the one that will interest us here is the use of a modifier called curve. This modifier allows to deform an object following a specific path defined by a bezier curve. So I'm going to add a curve modifier to my grid, and I'm going to place it just before the mirror modifier so that the deformation is taken into account by the mirror. Don't forget that modifiers always take into account all of what is above them. We can see that the curve modifier is waiting to be told which curve to use. It is therefore the time to create this curve. We add a curve to our scene. In edit mode, select all the points and press X to delete them all. Stay in edit mode and press the T key to display the left toolbar. Press this button, which will allow us to draw our curve. I think you can imagine what we are trying to do. We want to draw a curve that follows the surface of our object. By default, the drawing will not follow the surface of an object. To do this, you need to change an option that is only available if you ask for the toolbar to be displayed. it is in this toolbar that you will be able to ask for the drawing to be projected onto a surface. Everything is good. I will place myself as close to my surface as possible. I draw a line like this. Okay, some precisions. Of course, avoid making waves. You need to make your very straight as possible. Although you do your best, it will never be perfect. That's why you need to stay in edit mode and press the S and ZK and then 0. These will have the effect of flattening your curve, which now represent the exact path you want. Now, return to the grid and its curve modifiers. Use your freshly made curve in the modifier. So, this is going to need a little explanation. I think that anyone who have ever tried to use this modifier has spent a lot of time trying to figure out how it works. So, I'm giving you the key to success. You will save an hour. Don't thank me. I'm happy to do this. In fact, you can thank me by subscribing to the channel so as not to miss the next video of your devoted developer. For this modifier to work, the origin of your object and the origin of the curve must be in exactly the same place. Let's to do this right way. Select the grid and place the cursor on the origin of the grid. Now, select the grid, right-click, set origin to 3D cursor. Everything is in place. The game will now consist in finding the right axis of deformation. I don't have any absolute rules to give you here. It's always depends on the orientation of your object, so you just have to test. Currently, the deformation axis is set to X. To see the effect, I will move my grid along the X axis. So I press G and X. Okay, it's clear that this is not the desired effect. So I try the next option, the Y axis. To test this result, this time I will move along the Y axis with the G and Y keys. Okay, one more time. That's clearly not it either. Let's move to the Z axis. I think you've got it. To test if this is the Z axis, I'm going to move along the Z axis. This time is good. I'm going to place the edge of my grid on the edge of the hole. This can be quite confusing, but to move the grid up and down, I'm going to move along the Y axis. To complete the grid and close the wall, I will adjust the array X modifier, increasing the number of repetitions until the entire cut is covered. I will also adjust the number of vertical repeats, which in my case can be reduced. This time, it is the other modifier array Y that needs to be adjusted. Last adjustment, use the Displace Z modifier to position the grid more or less deep in the cut. That's it for this technical focus. I hope you have learned something, and please remember that your main software is Blender. The use of add-ons should not lock you into them. When you want to make something from an add-on, and you can't find the functionality that fits your request perfectly, don't get stuck on, oh, the add-on doesn't offer it. Blender is an incredible complete tool. If the add-on doesn't offer a feature, there is probably a solution with Blender's native features. I will see you next time, and do not forget, we get tired of everything, except learning. Bye bye.